But the Bible said that God, when he came to visit us, okay, he came first as a son of man. Okay?
Amen.
He came to die on the cross. Because he came to the Jew people, okay, as a son of man. And after visiting Jewish people, he went back to the way he was. We say that he was the pillar of fire, okay? When he came back in that form, he met Paul. And he said that I'm Jesus, the one you are persecuting. Okay? And by the Bible said that he went now to the Gentile to become a son of God. Okay? And to the end of it, he must come back again as a son of David. Okay? But I want to say that he's going to be a son of David in the millennium. Okay? Son of David. You see how many? One, two, three. He's still the same God, but in different offices. Do you understand? And this one, so many churches, they don't understand this. The reason you see people arguing about Jesus is because they don't understand the deity of Jesus Christ. In this time here, he came in the flesh, okay, of Jesus of Nazareth, okay? Okay, Jesus of Nazareth, let's say that is. He revealed himself as the Son of God, the Son of Man. The meaning of the Son of Man is the prophet. He called Jeremiah, he said, the Son of Man. Because God is supposed to come as a prophet, he was called the Son of Man. Okay? And after that, he went to the Gentile dispensation, which is represented by the candlestick, which is seven church ages. Okay? Seven church ages. Okay. And then he revealed himself as a son of God. But to the last stage, he must be the son of David. But there's something you must know. He's still the same God, but here is not in the same body anymore.
Amen.
Do you understand? That the reason we spoke about the enough God, the one who's changing the form. And we spoke about, I'm going to tell you about kinos, their Greek word, which means God put himself in something else. It's God changing the form, because God is spirit to begin with. God is not human. Anyway, when we spoke about, we are talking about human, the human in God's understanding is the one who is like God. That means the spiritual man. Because the flesh, this one, for God, God calls it an animal. Do you understand? So Jesus was in Jesus, okay? God's name was Jesus. Why? Because it was revealed in the Son. Okay? The Son came to reveal the name of the Father. But when I said called Jesus Christ. And now people, they took this Jesus, the flesh, they think Jesus will keep this form forever. But Jesus, God, came in this body just to be a sacrifice.
Amen.
That's it.
Amen.
That's the reason when he was beaten, he didn't beat back. When he was insulting him, he didn't answer back. Because he came as a lamb of God. You understand? Mm. He's still the same person. This Lamb of God came to pay the price, to redeem the human race. But I don't say that, even the Bible says that God was in Christ reconciling the world with himself. Do you know what the reconciliation means? The reconciliation. You know what that means? The reconciliation means that I had a problem with you, against you, okay? And after that, we came to found the solution. I said, okay, oh, forgive me for what I've done. And you say, okay, no problem. It's the reconciliation. Do you understand? Because the human race was separated from God. Do you understand? When Adam sinned, there was a separation between us and God, which is called chasm, but not chasm. Do understand? And there was a contact between man and God, human beings and God. And God sent Jesus to come to establish the relationship between us and God. And that relationship, what that means, that God is going to get again in his people.
Amen.
But I want to say that it was in time of Moses, it was God above us. Mm. In time of Jesus was God with us. Mm. And in the last age is God in us.
Amen.
Still the same God. Mm. But the reason they say that the world or churches, we see him no more. The same way they didn't see him in his first coming. What did they say? They said, you are a man, you are trying to make yourself God. Jesus was just a man. And today people think that Jesus was a special man. He was a simple man. Mm. If he comes today, they will neglect him. They think that he's just a simple man. He didn't even look nice. Short man, very skinny man. Mm. But when he was speaking, the words which was coming from his mouth was God speaking. Mm. That the reason Peter, Paul, Matthew, all the disciples, they start following him. And they told them, how can you follow this man? They said, because he's got the word of eternal life. And it's still the same Jesus, which is Melchizedek, just changing the bodies. Yeah. And the body of Melchizedek, by what he said that, is the body of the word. The word body, which we call a theophany. Hmm. Do you understand? It's a Greek word as well. But I want to say that before Jesus became this one, he was first a theophany, which we call Melchizedek, which is the word. The word of God is not the Bible. The word of God is the pillar of fire, the logos. Do you understand? And this logos can change the forms. It doesn't remain like this forever. No, it changes the form. The angel of the Lord was coming to meet Barabbas. It was the same pillar of fire. Changing. When this pillar of fire met Moses in the burning bush, it was something like something else. But it was Melchizedek. It never changed. Still the same person, just changing the bodies. Okay. And people today, they're only expecting this flesh here
to come back.
This flesh, my mom said that the flesh of Jesus was in God. Because God can die. Is resurrected? Yes, but he can die. Even my flesh is not God. But a man's flesh is not God. But the spirit dwelt in Jesus was Melchizedek, the living God. And the same spirit came now dwelling in this man, it was God. And that same spirit dwelling in me and in you is God. And Melchizedek doesn't have the beginning, doesn't have the end. That means Melchizedek still living now. Amen?
Amen.
So if he's living, what is the form of Melchizedek today? But when I'm preaching the sermon called, who is this Melchizedek? He didn't say who was, he said who is in present tense. The challenge is to find now, today, who is this Melchizedek. This one is a big problem. And you'll never see it except you're born again Christian. Amen. Jesus told, Nicodemus, he said, you can't see anything if you're not born again. And Nicodemus was a doctor of the law, a good preacher, a teacher of the law. He told Jesus, oh, do you mean that I have to go back in my mom's womb to get to be born again? Jesus said, you are a good preacher. How can you have such understanding? This kind of understanding, isn't it? How can you think like that? And today people still thinking the same. Go and ask people, what is a new birth means? No one can give you the definition. So many Nicodemus today. That's the reason the people are missing Melchizedek. They can't see him. Because Melchizedek has took the form of a little child today. You find him in Brother Joseph. You find him in Brother Pete. How can you recognize Melchizedek? And one day Jesus, at the age of 12, they found Jesus Christ in the temple, confusing all the preachers. Confusing them. They came there with the books, and Jesus was explaining them the scriptures. At the age of 12 years old, they said, how come? Because Jesus was himself the Word of God. He was trying to explain to them who he was. You understand? And the Word of God belongs only to the children of God. Because the children of God, they are part of God. If you don't have the nature of God, you will never understand God. How can you understand God? But I want to say that God is known by revelation. When they were men say that, told by Barnabas, oh, me, I can't take the revelation. But the Bible said that if you can't take the revelation, that means you never understand God. Because the Bible said that he hides those mysteries to the wise and prudent and revealed it to the babies, those who want to learn. It's a revelation, isn't it? God revealing himself to the people. And the Bible said that what is the new birth? He said the new birth means God revealing himself to his people. And the only way for God to reveal himself to you is God to dwell in you. So God in you understands God. Don't understand?
Amen.
The deep calling to the deep. But I'm saying that Jesus didn't bypass his theophany body. He was Melchizedek and he came in the body of flesh. He said the difference between us and Jesus, he said, us we bypassed. So we came, see God, the attribute. This is God, yeah? Okay? We are there as attribute. Attribute means thought. Okay? We're in God as attribute. From God, we bypassed our theophany, we came in the flesh. You understand? But I want to say that the reason we don't know that much, and for this one we need faith to understand. Because you came from God, God Himself will give you faith to understand and to believe. But Jesus, before to come in the flesh, He came, He was a theophany. Okay? He came here to be a theophany, and then He became flesh, and He went back like this. You understand? But as you came like this to the flesh, now you have to go back to the theophany again to understand, to have a clear understanding. And by the way, that theophany, our spiritual body, is here, is the one that's giving us the understanding of the word. You understand? Is that part? Yeah? You understand? So what I want to show you here, I want to show you the difference between Melchizedek and Jesus. Okay. I said that Melchizedek was the king of Salem. Yeah? Salem, which means Jerusalem. Here, but why am I saying this? And this Melchizedek was not Jesus. Say amen. Was not Jesus. I mean, the body. Keep it in your mind. There was Jesus in Jesus. When I'm saying this, that means it wasn't that body. Why? Because Jesus had a beginning. Okay? But Melchizedek didn't have any beginning. That means it's not Jesus. You understand? But Melchizedek was living in the body of Jesus Christ. Is it clear? For He was God. And what made Jesus and God different, that Jesus was the tabernacle that God dwelt in. I never see someone explaining the deity like Baba. And the deity, knowing the deity, that's the victory. Because Bible said that Satan can come in so many forms, changing, making himself a believer, making himself a pastor. If you don't know the truth about the deity, you are lost. You are going to wait for something which is past already. That's what's happening to people today. Amen?
Amen.
And what made Jesus and God different, that Jesus was the tabernacle that God dwelt in. See, now Melchizedek, Jesus had both father and mother. And this man never had father or mother. Okay?
Amen.
Jesus had a beginning of life and he had an end of life. He says, this man had no father, no mother, no beginning of days or ending of life, but it was the same man, the same person. Do you understand? It's like, of course, let me make it simple for you. Because just this one, yeah, this fits the basics of the message. For you, it's the basic, but for some people, it's a big problem. So when Peter was seeing Jesus, he saw God in Jesus. But preachers, when they saw Jesus, they saw a little man, the boss of the demons. It depends what you see. Amen.
Amen.
I've got the bottle, I've got the water inside, okay? If I tell you, give me water, you never take the water like this to me. You put it in the bottle, okay? I'll take the glass, okay? I'll take water and put in the glass, okay? It's not the bottle anymore, it's the glass. This one is the bottle. But the main thing is water. So when it's in the water is in the bottle, what is that? It's still water, isn't it? When I put it in the glass, what is that? It's still water. My problem is not the bottle, not the glass, but the water. As long as the water is changing the recipient, for me, that's in the water. And the water is God. The bottle is Jesus. The bottle is Barabana. And the bottle is Melchizedek. Keep changing. You understand? And you and me today, we are the bottle. The same Jesus, the same Melchizedek, changing his forms and comes to us. And unbelievers will see it. Even message believers. Because Barabbas was the forerunner of the second coming of Christ, isn't it? How can you say in this message that you are expecting Jesus when the forerunner left the scene? It's not going to work. Because when John the Baptist was here, Jesus came, isn't it? And John the Baptist said, "Behold the Lamb of God." So the Messiah must be introduced to the people by someone. So if the forerunner is not there, that means the Messiah will never come. You understand? If you see the forerunner leaving the scene, that means Jesus, the coming of Jesus is past you. So simple. The thing is, Jesus is just changing. Melchizedek is changing. And the same water was in the bottle called Jesus. The same water came in the bottles called Matthew, Mark, Peter, all of them. The same water change came in the man called Paul. And the same water came in a man called Columba, Martin, so forth. In the way of redeeming his children. And the redemption, the first part of it, starting with Abraham over there, came through Enoch, all of them, all the prophets, came through until the time of John the Baptist. And John the Baptist was the one supposed to introduce the Messiah. And John the Baptist was the end of the Old Testament. Do you understand? When we came in John the Baptist, the redemption for the Jew people took place. And it was all. It came through John the Baptist and he introduced the word of God, which was Jesus. So after John the Baptist, it was over for the Jew people. Do you understand? Now it started for the Gentile. So for the Gentile, it started from Paul, Irenaeus, Martin, Columba, until Barabbas, it was over. That's the way God works. And what is doing after that? Jesus must come to redeem his people. There it was for Jewish people, and this side for Gentiles. And everyone was redeemed. Do you understand? And the redemption was over. But it's still the same Melchizedek. Because they saw him in the candlestick, he was revealed himself as a son of God. The son of man is the same God. The son of God is still the same God. And the son of David is still the same God.
Yes.
It's just changing the bodies.
Yes.
Do you understand? And my mom said that when he's going to come as a son of David, he's going to take his own church. In his church, he's going to dwell there. But I'm saying that he's going to take his redeemed subject as the temple. Do you understand? And the throne of God is always the man. So when is it come, and when the people will be expecting the man of God to come, they will see someone else. Because Jesus was dressing himself like this because in that time the people was dressing like this.
Yes.
So if Jesus comes today, he's going to dress like the people of this day.
Yes, sir.
Because if he comes today and dresses like himself like this, he's going to be weird.
Yes, sir.
So the people, they kept in their mind someone dressing himself like this. And this one is Satanism. But I said, I'm not worshipping something historic.
Yeah.
I'm not worshipping the historical Jesus 2,000 years ago. For that one, you don't need revelation to know that. You understand? To recognize this Jesus as God, you don't need revelation. Because everyone knows about it. But what I'm saying, I'm worshiping Jesus in his body today.
Yes,
in this day.
Amen. Yes.
You know, when Jewish people rejected Moses, they didn't want to, they didn't reject Jehovah. They rejected Moses. They said, we need Jehovah, but you, Moses, not you. But they didn't know that Jehovah God was living in Moses. You understand? I don't want this bottle, but I want water. We give you the bottle. We said, no, you throw it away. Where's water? The water is gone. I want Jesus, but I don't like Barabbas. Throw Barabbas away. You throw Jesus away. Isn't it? In that time, they said, Moses, why only you? Today you said the same. Why only we have God now? Because it's the way God works. You understand? God works in that way. The thing, someone told me that I've tried to check in the Bible, I didn't see Barabbas' name in the Bible. I said they told Jesus the same. They told Jesus, didn't find the name in the Bible. Because in the Old Testament, the name of Jesus is not there.
Yes.
Even the name of John Baptist is not there. And John the Baptist, this, the name of John, it wasn't in the Old Testament.
Yes.
The first time that name was given, it was with John the Baptist. And in the Old Testament, no one was baptized with water. The water of baptism wasn't there.
Yes.
And when John the Baptist came, he said, you have.
Be baptized, something
new. It was a big challenge for Jewish people. Most of them, they finished to hell. When Jesus looked at them, they said, your father is the devil. That's the reason the denomination is for the devil. You can't praise them, you say, oh, but Eric, you're a good brother, but I don't like brother, brother. How? The way I am is because of the message, isn't it? The way I act, I'm acting according to the message. So if you appreciate my behavior, that means you have to appreciate the message. What people are doing today, they want to be our friends, but they don't want to be. You don't want to be, you are not my friend. Let us make it clear. The message or not. Because this message, that's the reason for me, my family is the believer. Believers. Because with the believers, we came from the mind of God, then we came in the flesh. Before we come to the flesh, maybe my brothers and sisters, they came from somewhere else. Maybe they didn't come from God. Because if they came from God, they recognize the word of God.
Yes.
Because God is the word. So for me, my family is those one was there. Because this is the family. You understand? In God, there's the true family. So when we meet here, then we love each other. So my brother in flesh, if he doesn't like the message I believe, that means he's not my brother. I respect him, but my brother is those ones who believe the message. Because in them they've got Melchizedek, they've got the Theophany, me too, I've got Melchizedek in me, and we love each other. That's the reason I don't believe that there must be problems between the believers. Because we are making one family. Let me tell you that those people, all most of the people outside, they are fighting us. They don't like Barabbas. So when we are inside of the message, we can't fight among us. We must be united to fight against those people. Who is this Melchizedek? But what I'm saying is, it was Melchizedek, and this Melchizedek.
He
said, it was Melchizedek.
And Jesus was
one. But Jesus was the earthly body.
Yes, sir.
You understand?
My.
Born and fashioned after sin. Mm. Why? Because he came to take the sin of the world. To die on the cross. But Melchizedek doesn't have the beginning. He was eternal God, which was living in the body of Jesus, the body of time. So you can't take God and start God in the time, because it's eternal God. Born and fashioned after sin, God's own body, his own son, born and fashioned after sin. Mm. To take the sting out of death. Amen. To pay the ransom and to receive sons and daughters unto himself. Mm. You get it? That's the reason that he had a beginning, he had an ending. You see?
Amen.
The body was the man. Jesus was like just a man. But I say that the reason people they are doing the idolatry because they are trying to have an image of a sentiment, someone used to live long time ago. The image of the imagination of such a someone like Jesus. Because no one knows about Jesus. In the book of Mark, chapter 16, verse 12, when the disciples met Jesus, they didn't recognize him. Do you understand? They were walking with Jesus, not recognizing him. And when they got in the house, Jesus broke the bread, then the Bible says that their eyes was open and they recognized him and he disappeared. So God is not someone who's not intelligent that is going to come in the same face where everyone is going to recognize him. God knows exactly what he's doing. In every age, God always confuses people. They gave the promise, said, I will deliver my people with my own hand, mighty hand.
Yes, yes.
So people was expecting the hand to come from the sky like this. Say, my people, come. The mighty hand of God was Moses.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes.
Behold, I'll send you Elijah the prophet. That's Barabbas' name.
My.
You don't see Barabbas in the Bible? Barabbas is everywhere in the Bible. Revelation chapter 10, that's William Branham.
Yes, sir.
Malachi 4, Barabbas. Mm. Luke 17, 13 is Barabbas. Mm. Even you go to the book of Genesis, you find Barabbas. Mm. Because Barabbas said that if you don't see Jesus in every verse of the Bible, go back and read it again. Mm. Because Jesus is everywhere. When you see Jesus, you see Barabbas and you see me. So many people tell them Barabbas is God, they say, no! You tell them that you are God, they say, yes. How can you be more God than Barabbas? How can you be holy, more holy than Barabbas? If Barabbas wasn't God, that means Satan preaching to us. Do you understand?
Yes.
One day, a brother told another brother, said, the thing is, you are trying to divinize or to make Balabanam God. And that brother said, okay, so you want to make him Satan then? Yeah, because there's no in between. If Balabanam wasn't God, it's Satan. That's it. And you leave the message. And the purpose of the redemption, it was to make us God.
Yes.
As long as you don't see yourself as God, that means you don't understand the redemption.
Yes, sir.
So if Balaam's deity is a big deal for you, what about your own deity?
My.
Because the way I'm standing here, I'm God myself.
Right. Yes, sir.
If I'm not God, I can't preach to you. I'll preach to death, isn't it? You are God's. The Bible says you are God's. David said that in Psalms 82. He said that you are God's. The people see just a little boy with his glasses going to the academy. They say, oh, his name is Israel. But never that I see Jesus Christ.
Yes.
When someone is playing the guitar there, who's that? It's Jesus Christ. The one who's playing there the keyboard is Jesus Christ. Those who are singing there, they are Jesus Christ. So which Jesus Christ are you looking for? God in morph, changing forms.
Yes, sir.
And he said the world will see me no more. That means even you explain to them,
they won't see.
They can't see.
Yes, sir.
They won't see. Why? Because they've got their own imagination. But the Bible said, lean not to your own understanding. Yes. They've got their own understanding of Jesus Christ. When you bring them something new, they explode. Yeah. They go, boom. It was the same in that time. When Stephen said, oh, I can see the heaven open, I can see the Son of Man sitting at the right side of God, right side hand of God. And those preachers start renting their blood. And they stoned him and he died. In every age, the deity was the problem. And it's still the problem. That's why what I'm saying that God is a God of separation. There's no friendship between believers and unbelievers. I'm telling you.
Yes.
Those who don't understand, one day will understand. Yeah. Amen. Because they will never understand you. No one can understand. So you can't explain God. Do you understand? What I'm doing here, I'm not explaining God to you, but I'm just trying to push you and go read the word of God. You understand better. Jesus was trying to explain to them, but they didn't understand. They said, oh, tell us, who are you? He said, I'm the Son of God. So what? He said, I'm the bread from heaven. So what? So listen to what he said. He's saying he's the bread from heaven. Listen, we know your father, we know your mother. How can you say you came from heaven? Do you understand? Jesus said, but you told me that you are the seed of Abraham. They said, yes, we are children of Abraham. He said, no, if you were the seed of Abraham, you recognize me.
Yes, sir.
Because in that day, Abraham recognized God in human flesh. That's the main thing. Who's God today? Do you understand me before you hear preaching to you? Can you see God in me? If you can't see God in me, that means you are not the seed of Abraham. Amen? If you can't see God in William Branham, you are not the seed of Abraham. Because it took only Abraham to show him what is going to take place. He told Abraham that fire is going to come down in Sodom and Gomorrah. And those people then, they were doing party, feasting, dancing, nightclubs, doing things. But they didn't know that the judgment has been turned to Abraham. And Abraham knew that. And God sent two angels to get out Lot and his family only. So all of them, they left there still waiting. Today, people, they don't know what's taking place. But one day, the fire will come down. But we know. Why? Because we've got our bodies, their glorified body. But when I say that those bodies, they are somewhere here. Do you understand? See, once the bone fall down here, straight away in 2 minutes, I'll be 18 years old. I am a boy.
My.
Full of hair. like one of these ones. Amen. No need of glasses because my eyes will be perfect.
Man, yes, sir.
Amen. But when I said we are going out to become young again, so they don't know. But today is the judgment day. Amen. Let me finish. But I would say that yeah, he said, but this perfect body, the body of Jesus, in commemoration of the illness of our resurrection, God would not suffer that holy body to see corruption when Jesus died. Because he created it himself and brought it forth and resurrected it and set it at his right hand. The body of Jesus Christ, the same one, changed. And the same body became the pillar of fire. It changed the form. And he said, I'll come back to you. When he went after a moment, he came back. After 10 days, he came back in the upper room. And he came in the inside also. So the people was thinking that Jesus left, but Jesus was there. Mm-hmm. But now Jesus is walking as Peter. Mm-hmm. Walking as Mark, Matthew. You understand? And those two, the couple, it was those one, they didn't give money.
Ananias
and Sapphira. They thought it was dealing with Peter, but it was Jesus himself.
Yes.
God in his people. The same way he said it. Amen. People say, say now if the same man is risen from the dead, living in his church, and he said, these things that I do, shall you do also. Is that right? Because he was going to the Father. In other words, he said, I came from God, I go to God. Mm. Jesus was none other than Jehovah God. He was God, the Father, revealed in human flesh as the Son of God, he takes him out of the world. He was Almighty God. God dwelt in him like the Holy Spirit dwells in him as
today. Yes.
Amen. So, but I was saying that the same. If you take the water of the ocean, it's said the same chemical you've got in the ocean is the same chemical you've got in the spoon.
Yeah, amen.
So if you are son of God, that means you are God yourself. Amen. That's the victory. The victory is to become God. It's not to know God, but to become God. The thing is, so many people, they've got so they've got the knowledge, they went to Bible schools, studying about the Bible, but they don't have enough God in them. It was the same in terms of Jesus. When Jesus came, because he was the one who started confusing them, the same way we are confusing them today. Amen. And the Son of God was submissive to the
Father.
The Father was in him. Because the Father is the Word. He had submission to the Word of God which was in him. And a servant of God today is submissive to the Father.
Yes.
Is that right?
Amen.
Who's the Father? The Father is the Word of God in you.
Yes.
You must submit yourself to the Word of God.
Amen.
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 Who is this making servant?
My.
The same God changing his master. Amen. Let me take one cut here and then. Oh. I said a moth. Let me just say, we'll talk about it next time. A moth is God, the God who's changing forms. And Kenos, yeah. You want it like this. Okay? So when God changes the form, what's he doing? He's pulling himself out. Okay? See, if God is here. Hold on. Yeah?
Amen.
This is Moses. Yeah? And here you have Jesus. So when we talk about kinos, is God changing his form? He's no longer Moses. Everything was in Moses is now in Jesus. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
God can know himself by changing the form. And he said that it's going to be in the last age, it's going to be in his church. Okay? Because God doesn't work with groups, we take one man.
Mm-hmm.
William Branham. Okay? Okay?
Mm-hmm.
God puts himself again in kinos, okay? So Jesus is no longer there. All God is now in Barabbas. Mm. And Barabbas left the scene now in the bride. Kinos again, okay?
Mm.
Everything was in Barabbas. Barabbas is no longer there. Where's God?
In the bride.
In the bride.
Yes, sir.
Still the same God. But man said that God is hiding himself in simplicity.
Mm.
And this one, no one can see it.
Mm.
God bless you. Mm. In this second. For you say, and what you say again. Thank you. shown us who is this man, Kisedek, Lord. We thank you for your grace, Lord. We thank you for the revelation. We thank you, Lord, for this wonderful meeting. Bless our children, Lord. Give them, Lord, your own understanding, Father. We know that we can preach, Lord, but the understanding must come from you, Father. We commit them all in your hands. We commit, Lord, the main meeting, the material of your hands. We will fast in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. And you say, amen.
Amen.
Sorry for keeping you for a long time. God bless you. Take a break and come back.